In this section, we'll look into the fourth and the final mandatory check, which is known as fatigue analysis. As the name suggests, this analysis is performed when the load is fluctuating with time and you are having cyclic loading condition to be considered. The cyclic loading check has got three parts. The first one is known as screening criteria check. This criteria decides whether the fatigue analysis is required to be performed or no. The second part consists of the actual fatigue analysis. Again, there are different alternatives which are available. Here we will be considering elastic fatigue analysis check in this session. And the third one is known as ratcheting check. So what is ratcheting and how it is performed will be covered later in this session. Let's first consider the elastic fatigue analysis using the SN curve approach. So we are considering a geometry of a nozzle to head junction. So you are having an hemispherical head to a cylindrical nozzle junction, and we are interested in finding out life of this particular structure under fluctuating internal pressure. In this case, the design pressure of the vessel is given as 10 MPa, and the pressures are fluctuating between 9 MPa to 3 MPa during the operation. And the geometry of the model is as given in this figure. In order to perform fatigue analysis, the initial steps are exactly identical to that of the static analysis. You first prepare the finite element model, apply the boundary conditions and the loading which are acting on the geometry. So in this case, the head internal pressure, nozzle internal pressure, and the nozzle axial thrust force is given. An important aspect of fatigue analysis is establishing the correct element size. For example, if you consider a mesh which is generated with element size as shown, you will get the maximum stress as 348.8 MPa. By making some refinement in the mesh, the result of the peak stress improves to 356.5 MPa. And if you make further refinement, you get another value of stress. But as you can see, these two stresses are almost matching to each other as compared to the difference between first and second. The second and third are almost same. So that means any mesh size between these two discretization levels is okay for doing the fatigue analysis. So since the fatigue analysis depends highly on the value of peak stress, the accurate estimation of peak stress is important, and for which the correct selection of finite element size is to be determined accurately. Using the finite element mesh of appropriate size, you can obtain the amplitudes of the stresses, first corresponding to design pressure, and then corresponding to the cyclic loading. So corresponding to pressure of 9 MPa and 3 MPa, which are the maximum and minimum pressures, you obtain the values of stresses, and from that you calculate the amplitude of the stress. So you can first calculate what is the variation of stress. So you are having sigma max and sigma min, and based on that you can calculate what is the value of amplitude of the stress. So that is what has been calculated here for first, second and third principal stress. Using these values, we can calculate the amplitude of equivalent stress, which is the von Mises stress for the ASME section and division 2 design code. So you obtain the equivalent value of stress amplitude corresponding to given load cycle. We will use this value to enter into the SN curve for the given material. The design code gives you the values of SN curve. The latest design code, instead of curve, they give it in terms of table or equation. In this curve, the horizontal axis is the life number of cycles and vertical axis is the stress amplitude. We have calculated the stress amplitude in the previous slide. Using that value, you enter into the curve, reach the curve which is for your material, and from there you will calculate the value of the life, which in this case is 2 into 10 to the power 5 cycles. You compare this life which is calculated against the required life. So required life, for example, typically it is 100 cycles per day. If that is the value of the cycles, then 365 days multiplied by 10 years assumed life, you require the number of cycles minimum to be 3.65 into 10 to the power 5. Since our estimated cycles are smaller than the one which is required, that means you need a change in design, or you require improvement in design in order to satisfy the criteria of fatigue analysis. This improvement could be done in terms of changing the geometry. So since we are dealing with the peak stresses, in this particular case the design can be improved by providing a higher corner radius. Or by changing the shape of the nozzle, or by changing the thickness of nozzle. This or any other way can be adopted for improving the design. In general, the results are very sensitive to load variation, as well as the accuracy of FE results depends on the mesh size that you are using. So mesh size is an important criteria, and the load variation need to be accurately determined before you carry out the fatigue analysis. Also, you have to consider that the SN curves given, they are having certain statistical variation contained in them because of the very nature of the fatigue phenomena. You have to keep sufficient amount of margin between the life that is estimated using SN curve and the life what you want. Although the design could take care of this statistical variation, most of the practicing engineers take an additional factor of safety using the values which are obtained using this particular code. Let's look into the other aspect of fatigue analysis, which is ratcheting. Let's see what is ratcheting and how it is checked. Again, for performing ratcheting analysis, there are different approaches available. Here we are using the simplified elastic plastic approach for checking for ratcheting. The ratcheting is defined as progressive incremental inelastic deformation that can occur in a component subjected to variation of mechanical stress, thermal stress, or both. What in summary it means is that if you take a structure, so for example a nozzle to head junction, and apply certain cyclic load to this particular junction, so you are applying internal pressure which are fluctuating, you will find that after the application of initial cycle, this particular geometry will undergo some deformation, exaggerated here. When you remove the load, the model will go back to its original position, or try to go back to the original position. The ratcheting is a phenomena in which after every successive cycle, there will be some permanent deformation. If the load is sufficiently high, there will be some permanent deformation of the structure. And if this permanent deformation keeps on increasing after every load, you will find that the structure will fail after a certain number of cycles. So we don't want that to happen, and this particular phenomena where there is a progressive incremental deformation of the structure is known as ratcheting. In order to prevent ratcheting, there are different approaches which are available. Here we are looking at the simplified elastic plastic analysis for checking against ratcheting. The approach works as follows. Again, we will illustrate with the help of an example. So the same nozzle to head junction what we seen previously, when it is subjected to first cycle. So the first cycle corresponds to the pressure from 0 to the maximum pressure. You will get certain stress distribution. When you go back to the second cycle, you will get another stress distribution and so on. If you plot the stress distribution versus time, so on the y-axis you are having 1 Mises stresses at location A. So location A is the location where the highest stresses are occurring, and plotting against the time, you will find that at the end of first cycle you will get highest stress, which corresponds to about 263 MPa, and after every cycle this particular value keeps on changing. And if this stress value stabilizes, as in this case the values are stabilizing, then you say that the ratcheting check has been satisfied and you don't have to worry about the failure in this particular case. But suppose these stresses, they keep on increasing after every successive cycle, that is after the first cycle, the second cycle the stresses increase, the third cycle they further increase, fourth cycle they further increase, and so on, then this trend will be dangerous. And here it signifies that the ratcheting is detrimental and acting against the safety of the vessel, and then you have to take appropriate action in order to make your design safe. In place of checking the stress variation, you can also check the displacement variation. That is, in this case, instead of plotting the stresses on y-axis, you can plot the radial displacement at any point of the model against time, and again this displacement should stabilize after a particular time. So in the second graph, the radial displacement at point A is shown against time. So initially it increases, and after each successive cycle indicated by dots, the displacement is remaining permanent, so it doesn't vary with respect to time. That means the design has stabilized, and hence the ratcheting check has been satisfactorily obtained and no further modifications in the design are required.
Let me summarize the topics covered in this session. We started with an overview of different approaches provided in ASME Section 8 Division 2 for conducting design by analysis of pressure components. We have seen that there are four mandatory checks to prevent failure against corresponding modes of failure. The check to prevent failure by plastic collapse, wherein the entire vessel cross section may fail leading to catastrophic failure of the equipment, is checked first. We covered the elastic analysis approach in detail and described the concept of stress categorization and stress linearization in this context. We also briefly covered alternative approach of limit analysis. Each of the approach was illustrated with a real life analysis case. The check against prevention of local failure using elastic analysis approach was covered next. In this check, the focus is on preventing failure from a local spot in the equipment, in contrast with the total cross-section failure which was checked in the previous plastic collapse case. The third check is to prevent failure by buckling, which was illustrated with a supporting case. The fourth check is to prevent failure by action of cyclic loads. An elastic analysis approach utilizing material SN curve was described. Also, the procedure to avoid failure by ratcheting was discussed. I believe that this session equips you with an understanding about various procedures which are required to perform design by analysis of pressure equipment. I hope you are benefited by this session. Kindly let me know if you have any queries. See you again in the next session. Goodbye, everyone.